is one of three things. It's an event space, it's an accredited museum for women's history, and it's a library. My role in a library is adult literacy and numeracy tutor. The activities that take place in the library are very wide and varied. They are from one-to-one learning sessions to big events that take place in the event space. There's Story Cafe that takes place, there's craft making sessions, there's events where women can come and just be in a safe environment for women only. You can hear about new writers, established writers and authors and poetry. There's a lot of exhibitions that run throughout the year to do with art and design and photographs. And so many different things. And there's heritage walks as well that take place, run from the library but in the locality in Glasgow as well. Safe space in the library is something where women can come and enjoy, particularly for events that are for women only, where they can come and feel that they're in a safe environment and it's warm and inviting. They can just come and find a wee corner in the library and just have a cup of tea, a chat with somebody, or just sit quietly and study whatever they may be, or read a book. For them to feel that, to feel really welcomed and valued and part of the whole environment that's the Glasgow Women's Library. I think the difference between the Women's Library and an ordinary library space is very apparent. When you do come through the doors at GWL, I think there's a tangible sense of just warm, inclusive, at the same time diverse, but very much an inviting space where women can feel, oh, it's really comfortable in here, you know, I want to stay, I want to spend more time than I'd planned to. And just for the openness amongst the regular visitors here, the volunteers and the members of staff who make all those people make it a very special place. Sometimes men say to me, oh, men don't have a men's library, and well, we say men are welcome too, but it's just that 25 years ago, that innovation of that innovative move to create a space for women, you know, has definitely blossomed and grown into what it is today, and it's very much celebrated by women in Glasgow, Scotland, Britain, across the world. I think it's definitely a treasure, without doubt. The visions and values to create another space like this would be something, if I was to create something like this, I would definitely mirror where I could, you know, the visions and values of the Glasgow Women's Library, and just to replicate that if it's at all possible, because I think the combination is definitely got the ingredients right, you know, with regard to making people feel involved and included and welcomed, and at the same time the broad diversity of the different type of ages of women that come in through the doors at GWL. If I was to replicate that, then I would very much use this as my guideline. think to create a special place for women, you need several elements. I'm not an expert with regard to a space for people to learn, but I think there's got to be enough resources for women to feel that there's a little bit for everybody. You know, whether it's books, whether it's treasures like archive, whether it's arts and crafts, whether it's dance, whether it's theatre. Some of the things that I've been involved in the past year, whether it's activities outside. The locality of a special place is very important as well. If I was to create a dream woman place, that would, I would definitely choose an old building, and something with lots of character. Find that would be almost quite difficult for me to do on my own, but I would, I would get as many people on board who were similar in the type of people that work, the women that work here, you know, to get that the creativity, to get the actual physical building right, you know, to get that special ingredient that makes the women's life do what it is, yes.
That's why I'm always hanging round you. Do I love you? Oh my, do I? Honey, honey, did I do?